What's up, everyone? How you guys doing? I'm Annoying Artist, and this is Tom Girl Podcast. Oh my god, I have not said this in so long. It's been like almost 6 months since I've been here, and honestly, I miss you guys. I miss you guys, and y'all are so good. Y'all are so good. Y'all are too kind. Y'all are like way, way too kind. Y'all are way too kind because it's like y'all will never let me slip. Like, damn, like y'all won't let me be regular is what I'm trying to say. Like, I can never be regular, like for real. Like, if I haven't been on the gram, Instagram in so long, they'd be like, yo, where the hell you been at? And I just be like, what? I've been around. I'm here. You know, I'm just like, y'all are good. Y'all are fucking good people. It's like, shit, let me be fucking regular. Like, I swear I'm a regular ass person. I'm a regular ass person. That's what I'm trying to say. Just let me be fucking regular. So I just gotta take you back to my summer, because I have had one wild, crazy summer with like dealing with my depression and anxiety, having my girlfriend or the girl that I was dating, she just broke up with me, didn't even give me an explanation why. Okay, I go to Miami, I get my camera stolen. I'm like, okay, cool. I have insurance. Come back, file a claim. Did get the money back. Whatever, cool. The camera, don't even give a shit about the camera. I'll buy another one. Got my camera stolen. And then one day I was so depressed. I was home from work and I was laying in my bed and someone kept ringing my bell. Someone kept fucking ringing my bell. And I was like, yo, who the fuck is ringing my bell? So I got up, you know, I can never hear them. They never say anything. So I like buzzed them in. So someone's like knocking on my door and I'm like, what the fuck is this? And they're like, this is Ariana Sullivan. And I'm like, yeah. And they're like, oh, this is, you have a paper from like Kings County Court. I'm just like, you gotta be fucking kidding me. Like, are you serious? Are you serious? And I will say this one thing only, guys. Pay your taxes, okay? Because you do not want to owe IRS. You do not want to owe the government, because they will come after you. They will attempt to garnish your wages. And I'm just like, who the fuck do you guys think I am? Like, do I have an L on my forehead? Do you think I'm like Lauryn Hill? Because I don't pay my taxes and I just like cancel everything or something like that. I'm just like, I was just like, okay. I looked over the papers, I read it, and I was like, okay, this is for real, this is serious, but I'm gonna go back to bed. I'm gonna go back to bed now, and I'm gonna deal with this later. So I go back to bed, I kind of like just dropped it on the floor, and I was like, well, guess you got me there. I guess you got me there. So the next morning I woke up and, you know, I kind of thought about it and I looked at it and I was like, okay, this is like really serious. You really might need to like hire an attorney because you're in some deep shit. And I was like, there's no time to be sad and be crying in bed. You need to get your shit together. So I called mama. I called my mom. I was like, mom, you know, yeah, you know, people were like knocking on my door and they were like, so I was like, mom, I have to hire an attorney, and I have to hire an attorney like now because I need to take care of this and I need some money. And I told mom, and I was like, mom, I'm sorry, I apologize. She was like, okay, I'm gonna give it to you this one time, but you need to like get your stuff together. And I was like, yeah, you know, you're right, you know, I gotta be better. So I was like going through so much and then like being depressed, and it was like, it's so weird now because like now I'm in a better place, a more happy, healthy place, and that's great, that's good. And it's like fall and it's getting cold. It is cold as shit though, like for real. And it's like, I love it, but it's like now I kind of want to be more, I want to go out and I want to socialize more. And I kind of feel that I'm a little late to the party because when I show up, there will not be any more parties because it's getting darker, it's getting colder, people are starting to shiver and recede. And I'm just kind of like, hey guys, I'm here, I want to party. And I'm like, girl, where the fuck you been? And I was just like, yeah, I know. It's none of my business. So yeah, it's been a crazy summer, and if I can say one thing and one thing only, it's that you do not want to owe Uncle Sam, you do not want to owe the government. So I had to go through this whole big thing, That took a lot of money. That took a lot of time. And I had to hire an attorney. And he pretty much was like, okay, all these bank accounts you got one in New Mexico, you got one in Florida, zeroed them out. $0. So I was like, okay, you know, okay. So I'm kind of glad that that is done and that that situation is handled, because Lord forbid I cannot have my wages garnished, like, at all. I'm just like, I'm like a small fish, like, in a pond. I'm not even in a lake or an ocean. I'm a small goldfish in a pond, and you come after me, and I'm like, wow. You know, things fall apart. Things fall apart. And it's like, I gained so much weight. I gained so much fucking weight. I'm not like fat, fat, but like, bitch, I'm fat. And I know I'm fat because like when I was on that Zoloft and stuff like that, it makes you very chill. And you know, I kind of eat more, kind of pick up more pounds, and you're happy and you're sleeping and you're not exercising as much as I used to, or I should. So one day I'm like, you know, riding home, and you know, I'm on the train and I'm sitting there, and I felt my stomach like kind of fold over my pants, you know, just like, well, hanging over. I felt my stomach like hanging over my pants. And I was like, Ariana, why the fuck is your stomach hanging over your fucking pants right now? Like, bitch, you need to fucking get in the gym. You need to fucking lose weight. Because, bitch, you are just putting on the pounds. You are just packing on the fucking pounds. And I knew that shit was bad, too, because, like, I had FaceTime my granddad, and I was talking to him, and he has glaucoma in one eye. And he looked at me, and he was like, Ari, you? He's like, you look like you're gaining weight. You look like you're gaining weight, like your face. And I was like, And I thought about it, and I was like, damn, if he thinks I gained weight, I probably did. Like, for real. For real, like... So that's another thing that I'm working on, because it's like I don't take that stuff anymore. Like, I'm off that stuff. So now I'm like, yo, what's up? I'm gonna party. Like, what's good? But yeah, like, I was chilling this whole summer, you know. I was just like, it's none of my business. Gain a little pounds. It's none of my business. So, I wake up this morning, y'all, and I get on Twitter, and I log onto Twitter dragging Quinta Brunson for her wig that she decided to wear and that she liked. So, I do have a picture, and I'm going to put the picture up on the video. This is Quinta Brunson, and this is her wig. She says she felt really good in the wig. She likes the wig. She felt cute, sexy, beautiful. I don't see the problem with the wig, right? Y'all are so mean, though. Y'all are so mean. Y'all will not let people live. Like, live and let live. Y'all will not do it, right? Chick feels good about herself. She's expressing that she feels good about herself. And someone had to come in there and say, look, I see what you're trying to do, but this wig is not it. And I was like, damn. So then she was like, oh, I have time today. She was like, I have time today. And she like skewed her wig and she like turned it to the side. And she was like, oh, how is this? Is this better? And I was like, I like her for real. I was like, oh, my God, I like her. It was funny. But I'm like, why won't y'all live and let live? Like, why are y'all dragging Quinta in her wig? With, like, no shame. And then I'm just reading the comments, and they're just like, yeah, I'm so glad somebody said something. Because this wig is not it. Oh, my God. y'all are so funny. Anyways, so yeah, That was what was going on Twitter this morning. Y'all were dragging Quinta and not letting her live in her truth. She likes the wig, guys. She likes the wig. Let her have the wig. Leave her alone. So in other words, let's talk about music. LMI, she just released her album. I do not have much to say about LMI besides LMI just released an album. And I don't know what the buzz is. And I will say this, her album does not suck. It's not a bad album. I did listen to two tracks, only two tracks. That's as far as I made it. I downloaded it to go back to listen to it, but I only listened to two tracks. It was like, hello, my name is... And I'm just as like, every single track is like her talking, and it's like her, it's like an intro to her. And I'm like, sis, we get it. You're British. We fucking get it. Like, who is this boring ass bitch? Next. That's all I have to say about LMI. Like, who the fuck is this boring ass bitch? It's not a bad album, okay? She does have some bops. That's what I've been hearing. I heard it a little bit. I'm like, oh, all right. She has some bops, but it's like, this is none of my business. This is none of my business. All right, so we're going to do a quick break right now. And I'm going to go. I haven't done this shit in so long. Oh my God, I am so rusty. I am so fucking rusty. This right here is Apple Cherry by me. So, I just want to catch y'all up and let y'all know, like, you know, what I've been up to was none of my business. It's none of my business. Yeah, so things fall apart. Things fall apart, and I had to learn, and I had to grow, and I had to learn to love myself, love on myself, respect myself, know that I'm enough. And, you know, I had to say to myself, yo, I can never lose again. I will never lose again because I fucks with myself more than anybody else. I love myself more than anybody else. I fucks with myself more than anybody else. So it's just a learning process. It's just this whole 2018. Like, shit was crazy. It was like the beginning of the year. You know, like, even like the end of 2017. Even the end of 2017, just like everything is just kind of like winding down and I'm like chilling. And then 2018 comes and it's like I meet someone and I fall in love with the person outside of my race. And I experience so many different things and we're like in love and it's moving so fucking fast. And then all of a sudden, so fucking fast, you just hit a roadblock and just everything falls apart. And it's like I come back, my whole world is turned upside down. I'm getting sued left and right. I owe the IRS money. Like, literally, it's fucking crazy. And I'm an Aries. Okay, I don't fake my feelings. I can't do that. I'm like, people, I have to understand what people come to me for or what people like me. I think I'm unique and I'm authentic in my own way, that I'm a really good storyteller and I can do that really, really well. And I think I inspire people, which is great. But in order for me to do that and be, I have to be as authentic as possible. Like, that's why I could never be a social media influencer, because I would fail you guys, because I don't really get that. Like, what would I influence you to do? I want to influence you to live your life the best that you can. You know, I don't want you to go buy things to make you beautiful or feel better about yourself. You know, fuck that shit. So I'm good though, for real. I'm good. My coin is good. We good. Now we are. Now we are. But you know, like, things fall apart and you have to learn and you have to pick yourself back up and you have to grow. So that's why I took a brief hiatus, pretty much. Yeah, I had to really handle some business. I had a lot going on to where I had to like withdraw and just take care of that shit. But I'm glad that it's over and that it's done with, and I can get back to my day-to-day life. And I'm sorry that I don't have much more to talk about. I do have much more to talk about, but I am really tired. I am really tired and I'm really exhausted. And after this, I just recorded 2 podcast episodes back to back. It's in the evening. I'm tired. I want to get home. My train is not running. I have an hour and 30 minute ride home. I'm not leaving my house tomorrow, although I did make plans to. Sorry, I'm going to have to cancel them. I'm just letting you know right now. And I still have to head into the TV studio to record some stuff. So I am tired and I'm going to have to end this there. But I'm excited to be back on my podcast. It's none of my business. And I'm going to have more guests on. And we're gonna talk. And I'm going to like fill you in on everything. But I just want to say, hey, like, what's up? Like, I'm here. Because y'all won't let me live. Like, y'all will not let nigga live. I'm like, yo, I'm regular. I'm a regular ass person. Y'all be like, yo, what is bitch at? What is funny bitch at? What is bitch at? What the hell? Something must be wrong with her because she ain't on Instagram. I don't be on Instagram like that no more. I get on there here and there because Instagram is so much now. And like I said, I don't have time to be reading people's. It's not a journal. Instagram is not your journal. Like, I'm sorry, I'm not reading your caption. You just post your pic and go, and I'll scroll by and I'll like it. That's it. Well, guys, we are out of time because I'm out of breath and I'm tired. I want to get home. So, guys, thank you so much for tuning in and listening to another episode of Tom Girl Podcast. This is Things Fall Apart, okay? Thank you guys so much, annoying artists. Good night from Manhattan. Bye.